dramatizes true medical mysteries told by the real doctors who solved them. Names and characteristics of patients and other individuals have been changed.
When a child comes into the hospital who's this ill,
he's never been this sick.
That's when you get real scared.
There are significant fat deposits and scar tissue.
It's like a shot of adrenaline.
I've never seen a seizure like this.
You've never seen this because this isn't supposed to happen.
She's dying right in front of my eyes.
It's a tightrope that we walk every day.
He's tacky in a sats drop.
Oh, no.
This is not the way normal blood's supposed to look.
You need it tested now.
You're searching. You're trying to find an answer, and you don't have one yet. We have got to act fast.
I'm either going to shock her to save her, or I'm going to shock her and kill her.
Oh, my God.
And everyone clear?
Colby, I want you to oversee Dr. Harper today. Her last evaluation was wanting in the bedside manner department.
Come over here and lie down, please. Look, you're making this worse for the both of us.
Just her last evaluation? She's got quite a mouth, that one.
I'll supervise her, don't worry.
Thank you.
It takes the average doctor about 18 seconds to make a character assessment about a patient. That's about how long it takes the average person to form an opinion about another individual. And once you make up your mind about someone, it's very difficult to make you think otherwise.
Doing so good. Oh, Mrs. Abbott, this is the attending physician I was telling
you
about.
How are
you? Dr. Cardillo.
Good to meet you. Good to meet you.
He presented to the ER yesterday with severe diarrhea and dehydration. We admitted him overnight for fluids and observation, and when I came to discharge him this morning, he had developed cyanosis and hypoxia.
Cyanosis is when a patient's coloration is blue. Means that they are not getting enough oxygen into the bloodstream to perfuse their tissues.
RESPs 20, BP 90 over 60. I started him on O2, 10 liters by face mask, but it doesn't seem to be making a difference.
This monitor, that's his heart rate, right? Yeah. 128 is really high, isn't it?
We have him on oxygen to try to bring that down.
So in addition to this child being cyanotic, he has vital signs that are way off the chart. He's hypoxic. He's tachypneic. He's breathing at a very rapid rate.
He's never been this sick.
I don't have any memories at all. What's his name, ma'am?
Josh.
Josh.
There's nothing going around his preschool that I know of.
Josh, can you sit up for me, please? Now, I don't hear any fluid in his lungs at all, but let's get a chest x-ray anyway. And we'll get an ABG as well.
Are you going to do an echocardiogram as well?
Mom's an office manager for an internal medicine group.
Okay, that's right. You'll be a great help to us then, ma'am, okay? Let's get the chest x-ray first, and then we'll go from there. And then we'll check on the echo later, okay? Great, thank you.
Most parents are not medically trained. They don't know what's going on with their child. They just know the child is sick. They have an innate gut feeling. Something bad is happening here.
Jessica Yang, 21 years old, had a seizure in a nail salon.
I'm fine, really. I just have a seizure disorder, and I totally forgot to take my pills. See? Not a big deal, but...
You make a lot of decisions on that first impression. In medicine, we call it a doorway diagnosis. So as soon as you see that patient, you already have a feel for what's going to happen. She was a seizure patient that forgot to take her seizure medicines. I wasn't even gonna run any blood work. It was that cut and dry.
Are you the doctor?
I am.
Yeah.
She's never been diagnosed with any heart problems.
Yeah, these things can sometimes present for the first time.
It could be an atrial or ventricular septal defect.
It could also be a problem with his lungs, too.
Cardiac silhouette looks textbook normal.
And the pulmonary vasculature is with the normal limits also.
In this particular case, my evaluation of the chest x-ray didn't help that much. It was a normal-looking chest x-ray. I didn't see any acute pulmonary processes that can be leading to this type of cyanosis or this level of cyanosis.
What is it with this kid?
Oh,
The owner called it. It was over by the time we got there.
I held her hand so you couldn't hit the floor.
So you're sisters.
No, but you know what? People ask all the time, which is so funny. He goes, got it. Not sisters.
No.
Vitals. BP 120 over 80, temp 98.6, no visible bruises or bleeding.
She was excited. She was very anxious.
God, he's so hot. Doctor, I don't mean to be rude, but my college graduation is tomorrow, and, like, I have to go to the airport in, like, what, 3 hours to pick my parents up? So I really need to leave. Pretty please?
I'll tell you what. Answer a couple questions for me. We'll run a couple tests, and if everything looks good, we'll have you out of here in 30 minutes, maybe an hour.
Oh, thank you so much. Colby?
Uh-huh?
She's tacky. Her heart rate's 130. I'm just excited about graduation.
We hooked Jessica up to our heart monitor, and she was in a tachycardic rhythm. That just means that her heart was beating a little too fast.
She's graduating in magna cum laude in economics.
When you're excited, it's like a little bit of an adrenaline rush, and that can cause an increased heart rate.
What seizure medicines are you on?
Just phenytoin, and I usually take it before I go to bed, but last night went to a party and I was drinking a little.
How much is a little?
Okay, a lot. But it was just beer. It was just beer.
Right.
Are you on any other medicines?
No, just that one.
Okay. Well, let's get a phenytoin level and a CBC and a Chem-18 while we're at it.
Okay. Excuse me, honey. This is just going to take a second.
Colette, she's having a seizure. Stop the blood draw. Emily, I need you to wait out for a minute.
There's no rhythm.
I need suction.
One of the leads is off. There.
She's in V-fib. Right before my eyes, Jessica went into a rhythm called V-fib. It's ventricular fibrillation, where the heart just starts quivering.
I've never seen a seizure like this before.
You've never seen this before because this isn't supposed to happen. Seizure disorders don't cause lethal arrhythmias. This was every physician's worst nightmare. You don't have time to think. You only have time to act.